vast potential. All of us have a lot of potential, and we don't live up to our potential. We perform very much within our potential. It's not only you and I who do not perform according to, up to our potential. Even high achievers, it is said, have utilized only about 20% of their potential. I mean, when I have chosen people like Bill Gates and Albert Einstein and Mahatma Gandhi, etc. No? So, we all can become much better than what we are, in whatever field we are. Now, there are people who claim that people who speak on personal development and self-development, that what you can do, I can also do, and you, I can rise as much as anybody else. I don't subscribe to that view. We may be different in our potential, but we all can be better than what we are in whatever field we are, whether cricket, football, law, economics, sleeping, teaching, whatever it is, we all can. However good you are, you all are very good, we all are very good, but however good we are, there's always room for improvement. In fact, they say that the biggest room in the world is the room for improvement. So, let us say yes to our potential. The whole idea is to raise talk. Say yes to your potential and become the best that you are capable of becoming. Okay. I will give you, it will not be a very esoteric lecture or theoretically, what shall I say, profound lecture. I'll give you a few 10 to 12 simple steps to unlock your potential. What we have to do. The first and foremost is, outgrow your self-imposed limitations. Okay. Outgrow your self-imposed limitations. See, we are born to win. In fact, there's a book called Born to Win. We are born to win, but we have been conditioned to lose. We have received a lot of negative inputs. From whom? From people who loved us. Our parents, our teachers, our elders, our neighbors, electronic media, the environment, etc. And we were easily conditioned. We were too young and we accepted everything as real, whatever they said. With the result, and what they said was negative, it was limiting. Even out of love, you know, if a child tried to put something, the mother would say, no, I'll do it for you. She is expressing love and care, but actually the message that goes to the child is, I'm not good enough, I can't do this. Okay? So, these lids were put on ourselves. So first step is we have to break free from this limitation, which are always self-imposed limitation. Okay? You all must have, since you are listening to all this type of talk, you must be knowing of the example of the circus elephant. You know it? You see the circus elephant, huge elephant, it is tied with a small chain. It can easily break it, but it never even tries. Why? Not because it is very obedient or something like that. Because when the elephant was young, when the elephant was small, they tied it with a string and he tried a lot to break free. He could not break free. So he accepted that I cannot break a chain. You see? So now he doesn't even try, he doesn't even look at it. He just accepts it. Something like that has happened to us. We have accepted. I've accepted that I cannot work on computers, as you said, no. And that is a very strong limiting thing, you know. So if you want to, you have to break free from that. Okay. So, and we all can be better than what we are. That's one thing. So the first step is to break free from our limiting beliefs and work towards the opposite. Okay. So, in other words, don't mentally handicap yourself. When we accept limitations, what we are doing is we are mentally handicapping ourselves, you see. Okay? So, break free from that. So, second would be, feed better messages to your subconscious mind. See, it is said the human mind is the most competent computer, most efficient. It has got infinite capacity to store data. Human mind is the most efficient and it has got infinite capacity to store data. Now, it is your responsibility to see that the proper data is stored. Your responsibility, nobody else's responsibility. In the first point, I told you that parents, etc., imposed limitation on us. Now, I am telling you that you alone are responsible. You are accountable, you are responsible, nobody else is responsible. You decide what data to feed in, what message to give to your computer. Only you can decide. People may say anything to you. People may say anything to you. You have to make the entry in the computer. So if I tell you, what's your name? I forget. Neharka, if I tell you that you're stupid, you're useless, you can't do anything, fine, I can tell you that. You can choose choice. Just to ignore it. What is this fellow talking, idiot, old man, he should be go to the asylum. So what happens? You're not affected by that. On the other hand, if you take it and make the entry, if I tell you you're useless, you can't do anything, you won't pass any examination, and you think, and say, yesterday also the professor told me the same thing. In college also people were telling me the same thing. My parents always told me that. My friends also told me that I'm a little bit. So what I'm adding more and more masala and putting that data. And what you put in is what you get. Okay? So you know the principle GIGO?
Garbage in,
garbage out. So if you put wrong data, if you feed incorrect data like I'm stupid, I'm lazy, I cannot do this, I cannot understand mathematics, etc. That is what you will become. That is what you will get. That is garbage in, garbage out. On the other hand, if you put positive data, correct data, good data, I'm capable, I'm energetic, I'm intelligent, etc. Then again, GIGO comes in. Now what is it? What does GIGO become? Good input, good output. Okay. So that is what you have to do. Therefore, it is imperative that you feed better messages to your computer, okay? Concentrate with his eyes closed, you know. I remember.
He meditates
while listening. Okay. Third one is
that. Your face is so handsome.
I agree fully. See, I'm giving an example of putting correct data into your system. Accept the data and add on to that. Okay. Develop a positive, healthy attitude. That is the third point. Attitudes are more important than facts. Attitudes control our performance. Okay. It is said that it is your attitude, not your aptitude, which will determine your altitude. How high you go up in life, how much you succeed will depend more on your attitude rather than your aptitude. Okay. So, what do you do that? Most people don't rise up to their potential, not because they lack knowledge or they lack skill or there's lack of opportunity, but mainly it is because of wrong attitude. Okay. So we need to, we have developed an attitude of non-belief in ourselves. We don't believe in ourselves. So we need to develop our attitude. We need to look at the limiting attitudes and work towards the opposite. Try to develop the opposite. For example, if you find your attitude is such that you are lazy and you procrastinate, you understand procrastinate, putting off things? So you can work that as dynamic action, okay, to overcome that. So that way you can do that. You are oversleeping, etc., you can work towards it, okay, fine. So this much only. Now, can you remember that almost each of these points which I am talking to you, there will be a separate talk on that. That is how it is. So that's why I am giving you only the crux of it, gist of it, the crux of it. Okay. Fourth is mind your self-talk. Do we talk to ourselves?
Yes.
You do? How much do you talk to us? All 24 hours?
No.
Why not? I think we talk all 24 hours. Yeah, even when I'm talking to you, there's another dialogue going on in my mind. Will I get a cab or not? But we talk a lot. That you'll agree. We talk a lot to ourselves.
Even in sleep.
In sleep, I don't know. I won't say that. Yeah. You talk in sleep.
The process is on.
Process may be on, yeah. But people take their problems to bed with them.
That's bad.
BAD or BED? Okay. So, talking, words make a lot of difference. And we are talking to ourselves. Words. You know, everything in this world is done with the help of words only. Poetry is written with words. What I'm doing is words only. Isn't it? If I give you a compliment, it is words only. So words play a very important part. So it is important. The words, you know, conjure up images and pictures in your mind. The moment I say fat or slim, something comes by. The word will be SLIM and immediately a picture comes. Okay, the image is coming in my mind. So it's important what you tell yourself. What you say is what's likely to happen. If you say, I don't think I'll succeed in the interview, I will fail in the exam. This is, you are sowing the seed of that to happen. You are sowing the seed of that to happen. Whatever you say, you are sowing. Even a small thing like you come out of your house and you say, I hope I get a cab soon. There also, you know, although it looks positive, but it's a negative statement. When you say, I hope I will get a cab, what you are saying is, I'm afraid I might not get a cab. I'm afraid. I hope I get well soon. I'm afraid that I won't get well soon. So we are all the time, and whatever we are saying is what happens. So supposing you say, if I come like for even a talk like this, if I come and think, I know I will forget my talk. I'm sowing the seed of that to happen. Okay. On the other hand, if I say that, I've given hundreds of talks, one more, what's that? Okay. So it's important that we use correct words. You know, words are our tools. They perpetuate and our action and performance. They predict and perform. See, a computer is a non-judgmental. What? Your subconscious mind is a non-judgmental computer. You agree? It merely takes in data. I should tell the people working in bank, when we got computerized in the bank, a computer is one of the branches. Although I say I don't know computer, I have enough managerial skills too. So, if a person is there on the counter and the ledger, those days were ledgers and all that, no? He may be useless at his work, it's a delayed. But if I have, normally I have only 1,000, 2,000 rupees in my account, and suddenly if I get a check of 5 lakhs, a credit of 5 lakhs into my this thing, that idiot who never thinks in his life will think, arre, isko 5 lakh ka kaisa mila? For last so many years I have been handling his account, he never gets a check of more than 50 rupees or 100 rupees. And computer won't think. It has gone 5 lakhs, 5 lakhs. Transferred to your account, transferred, finish. Okay, so it is non-judgmental. Therefore, we have to be very careful that what we put in, you see. So words are your tools, you know. So learn to use your tools appropriately. You know what is a hammer? What is it called in Hindi? Hathodi.
Mark tool. Mark tool means somebody says hammer.
Hathodi. You know that, no hammer. Now you use generally hammer to drive in nails in the wall, to put up such beautiful pictures and all that. You can also use it to knock your thumb. It's your tool. You can do it. And if you're careless, it might happen. Same thing is with your words. You can use it to motivate yourself. You can use it to unlock your potential. Or you can use it to put limiting thoughts in your mind. It's your choice again. It's your choice. You can do it. Okay? So, we'll say to this point, use your tools appropriately. Words are your tools and use them appropriately. Next point will be self-image. Improve your self-image. Self-image, some people say self-esteem. Okay. So what do you think? What is self-image? Yeah, deep down, really think about yourself. That is self-image, right?
The way you walk, the way you talk.
Everything, yeah. The way you walk and talk is a reflection of what you think you are. Everything, yeah, but it's all a reflection of yourself. So your self-image controls everything. You work and live within your self-image. You act like the person you think you are. You can write this down. You act like the person you think you are. It is impossible to act otherwise. If you deep down think that you're useless, you're going to act like that. That's why, have you read in the papers or have you known personally in life, there are people who win lotteries and get lakhs of rupees. And you meet them again after 12 months, they're broke. Like that. Because they, in their imagination, in their belief about themselves, they feel they're useless. They're beggars. They can't handle. There are people who can't handle money. Even if they have it, they can't. Okay. So, you have to improve your self-image. So, Because your image controls everything about you, your performance, your income, your status, your social prestige. Everything is controlled by this thing. Okay? And can you remember, so we have to work on our image. I would say that is the first point, to work on your image. Okay. Kindly remember that it is not what you are that holds you back. It is what you think you are not that holds you back. It is not what you are that holds you back. What you are is that you are a magnificent piece of creation with tremendous potential, tremendous abilities. We are talking about normal people, and there are people, of course, who have brain tumors and things like that. That's a different thing altogether. Yeah? So what you really are is this. So this does not hold you back. What holds you back is what you think you are not. You think that you are useless, you think that you cannot match up, you think that doesn't work, you think you don't deserve, etc. Okay? So, therefore, improve your self-image, and as she said, so that you believe, genuinely believe deep down inside you that you deserve, absolutely deserve what? Wealth, happiness, prosperity, good interpersonal relationship. Okay. 6th point. What will be the 6th point? Accept 100% responsibility. Right? Okay. It's very important, take responsibility for yourself. Okay. If anything is wrong, if anything is not up to the mark, up to the standard, say in your family, in your office, in your neighborhood, in your friend circle, wherever it is, don't start the blame game. Don't start blaming people or fault finding people. Try to improve the situation yourself. Okay? Be accountable, be responsible. Now our society is not working so well, etc. So today I have spoken to some people, and I mentally decided that I will get into the committee and do something. Instead of telling them this has to be done, that has to be done, let me do something. Now, which is a very strengthening and positive fact. Whether I do it or not is a different thing, but that is all. So take responsibility. See, you are not a puppet. You know what is a puppet? You are not a puppet in the hands of others. Okay? Your life is not a wooden plank on the river. Have you seen a wooden plank, how it goes tossed here, there, etc.? So you're not that. So what is it, your life? It's a ship with a rudder, and you're the captain of the ship. Okay? So take charge of your life. Take charge of yourself. And start doing things on choose to, want to basis. I want to do this. I choose to do this. You're talking about choice, etc. On that basis. Now, if I come and tell you, where are you going? I'm going to give a talk and help. Oh, what to do? They're calling me. I don't want to go, but still a lot to do. Now, what type of talk I will give if I have this attitude? Is it? If on the other hand, I say, I'm going to talk, there are at least half a dozen people waiting for me to come, and then it will come on YouTube, it might influence so many people, and nobody benefits. Every time I give a talk, I benefit. At least for 2-3 days, I'm a better person. Believe it or not. 2-3 days before the talk and 2-3 days after the talk. Then it might go off, but so people do benefit. Okay. Now, if I'm enthusiastic about that, then you won't believe me when I tell you I'm 78 years old. What is that? I'm 85. Okay. So, in short, don't accept life as it comes to you. Design your life so that it comes to you the way you want it. It's like building a house. You have an architect who will design it for you. So you also help him to design. So you design your life. We spend so much time in designing our clothes and our houses, and we don't design the most important thing, our own self, our own life. So design your life so that your life comes to you the way you want it and not in any other way. Okay. 7th point, set goals. There'll be a couple of chapter on talk on goals and goal setting. Without goals, you leave success to chance. The strongest motivation in human condition is setting goals. Goals give you meaning, purpose, direction, focus, everything. Okay. While setting goals, make sure that you prioritize them and balance them. You know, life goals, personal goals, etc. We'll talk about that later. Okay. And most importantly, state your goals in positive terms. What you want. Most of us always say what we don't want. I don't want to be sick. No, I want to be healthy. Okay. I don't want to fail. Oh, I want to succeed. I want to excel. You use superlative words. Not only just better, I want to excel. Okay. So, balance and prioritize them. Say them in positive terms. Yeah, what you want and not what you don't want. Most people tell what they don't want. I don't want to lose my job. Okay. Third point is that write down your goals. That's very important. Writing clarifies and crystallizes your thoughts. You try in a small thing also, just jot down. So you're going for a picnic tomorrow and you start jotting down points and you see it become clearer than when you just talk about it. So writing crystallizes and clarifies and crystallizes your thought. Writing is also constant reminder. See, very often our goals are not out of reach. They are out of sight. We forget them. I make a goal today that by next year I'll be very good in computers or I'll learn Marathi. For one or two days it is in my mind, I start looking things, etc. And then something happens, somebody in the family falls ill, somebody has to go, somebody, if you're working, you get a transfer order or whatever happens. And then you've forgotten that you had this till 6 months, then suddenly it strikes you again. So, put the goals down in writing. Writing has got tremendous, see this I put down in writing, not that I don't know, but I feel more confident. Okay, so put it down in writing and this has clarified, you see, I can go back on it anytime. And talk about it. Okay, so goals clarified. So goals are not out of reach; they are out of sight. So the best thing is to write down your goals and look at them often. There are people who say look at them morning, evening, etc. That I leave it to you, but do look at them, yeah, and take appropriate action. Okay, you are answerable to yourself. Be accountable and responsible. See, you are not doing it for somebody else. When we are young, we study to please our parents or to avoid getting hit by them. I remember when I was small, I used to never study. And the people used to hit me, but somehow I used to pass and all that. Then one day I told, when I was in our time, 11th standard was SSC, not 10th standard. But you sab yaad hoga aapko. So when I was in the SSC, I told my parents that one day it will come and you will come and tell me, stop studying. How much are you studying, beta? Take some rest. Yeah, and that is what happened actually. Okay. Because you do it for yourself, you are not doing it for somebody else. Okay, goals. Then, eighth point, ask the right questions. Now, it is important to ask the right questions. Your questions should be empowering, the questions should not be disempowering. When you ask the right questions, like for example, what can you give a right question? I'll give you an example. Supposing I say, instead of saying, why am I so fat? Why am I so obese? What answer you will get if you ask questions? So, your grandfather also was fat. Your grandmother is fat also. Itna khayega to kya fat hi hoega? Something like that you will get. So, why, instead of asking why am I so fat or why am I so obese, you change the question, ask the question, what can I do to become slim? See, if something goes wrong in your office or in your workplace or at home, wherever it is, don't get on the blame, this one. Take responsibility yourself. What can I do to improve the situation? Okay. Don't say whose fault it is, what it is. Don't ask, why am I so bad? Say, what can I do to improve myself? Yeah. These are empowering questions. Be careful about the questions that you ask yourself. Okay. Once you ask empowering questions, your mind, your creativity will be released and your mind will throw up innovative answers. Take it from me in writing. You will be surprised, you will be shocked. You ask an empowering question now and in the night when you are having dinner, you will get some creative answer, creative solution, creative suggestion. So it's very important that you ask the right questions. Now, point number 2 points more. Use what you learn. What is up? Use what you learn. What do I mean by that? How do you not know? Come on. Yes. Use what you learn.
Don't learn and be like a parrot. Or follow it.
Follow it.
Is that what you mean?
I mean apply your knowledge. Be open. Learn a lot. Okay? Go ahead, learn, join courses, join, listen to talks like that, read books, attend seminars, do whatever it is, learn, acquire more knowledge, but put your knowledge into action. The biggest gap in the world is the gap between knowledge and action. Knowledge is only knowledge. Knowledge is not doing thing. Knowing is only knowing. Knowing is not doing. Action is doing. Okay. An ounce of action is better than a pound of knowledge. Okay. Reward you for what you do and not what you know. So learn to put your action. Now, today I was talking to one person who is very closely related to me. He attends a lot of courses. You see. Now there's a course coming up at Singapore. It will cost about 1 lakh rupees plus all the travelling and all that. So he says, I'm thinking of going but I'm busy and all that. I said, what new will you learn? You see, Anthony Robbins is going to come and he's a great speaker. But he's not going to tell you more than what I've told you. I can put you in writing. Because after all, everybody has got access to the same thing. You know. Yes, he's good. But what do you want to go for? You want to go for a holiday? Yes, take your wife also and go enjoy yourself. If wife is not coming, take your girlfriend. It doesn't matter. Yeah, it's a, and learn. Yes, you will learn a lot. But you already have so much knowledge which you are not putting into action, which you are not using. What's the use of more knowledge? You, again, you balance it. Lack of rupees, lack and half rupees is important to you or not important. For me, it will be important. I won't. To somebody else, it may be nothing. One night at wherever it is, NSCI dome or something like that, it will go. Yeah? But you decide whether you can spend that much time. Etc. But the point is that you are not putting it into action. So the important thing is that put your knowledge into action. You will get results. That, and the world will reward you for what you do and not what you know. It's over? No, wait a minute. Visualization. We'll have a separate talk on that. You know what are affirmations? Affirmation is a positive statement given with emphasis and emotion, conviction. Stating what you want to be or have as if it is already so. Affirmation is different from goal setting. Goal setting is I will do this, I will do that. Affirmation is always in the present tense. Okay, goal setting will be I will bring my weight to 68 kgs by end of December 2018. Affirmation will be I weigh 68 kgs as if at present it is. Okay. So we'll talk more about affirmations, and affirmations can work only when your self-image is good, etc. Okay, so, but do that. Repeated affirmations turns it into reality. The trouble with trouble with people who practice affirmation is, and they give up is that, you know, you do affirmation for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and you talk to yourself for 24 hours. So while giving positive affirmations also, in that period also you give a lot of negative suggestions to your mind. Isn't it? You can examine your life. I'm speaking from personal experience. It has got nothing to do with written work. And you also, if you speak, you can speak from personal experience. All the time you are giving suggestions and giving opinions to your subconscious mind, to yourself. Okay. So affirmations we'll talk about. People can, but if repeated affirmations done sincerely with emotions, with conviction, okay. Turns it into reality. And practice affirmation. Along with that, you practice visualization. Visualization means to see something. You create a mental image, a picture in your mind, you see, of the thing that you want to have, to be, etc. The person that you want to be, etc. Look at it all the time, you see. And what you see is what you become. In other words, see what you want. What do I want? I want a Rashid Machand who's healthy, who's slim, trim, who speaks well, and who people appreciate his talk, I want that. So every morning, evening, I keep seeing that. I see Rashid Merchant like that. Okay? I'm not well, my legs are paining, I'm finding it difficult to walk. I want to walk like I used to walk before, then I keep seeing myself that way. Okay? That is visualization. And visualization also works if done properly. The last point for unlocking a potential is, or the reason why you don't rise to your full potential is that you don't have the inner desire, motivation to do that. We are all happy with where we are. We are okay, I mean we are happy with being okay. I'm fine, I'm earning money, I got a 2-bedroom flat in Bandra or in Borivali, whatever it is, I got 2 nice children. So I'm happy with myself. I'm good. And good is the enemy of the best. Good is the enemy of the best. It is very good for peace of mind to be contented. But we are now in a field of rising to your full potential, being what you are capable of being, the best that you are capable of being. So you are short-circuiting yourself if you do not exert and apply all these principles. So this inner desire, you must have this desire. Actually, if you analyze the whole thing, it will start with desire, self-image and action, etc. Other things are tools given, ideas, but these are the 3 main things. So what do we say in conclusion? Conclusion is like our beginning, that we all have a lot of potential. We are convinced now that we all can be much better than what we are. We have to decide to become better and put into practice all that we know about it. See, whether you think you can or whether you think you cannot, in both cases you will be right, as Henry Ford said, you know. Yeah, if you think you can become better, you can become better. If you think no, it's gone, then it's gone. It's all right. So then, since we are here in this world, I don't know how long we'll be there, why not do our best to rise to our fullest potential? Okay? And always remembering that success is a journey, not a destination. You don't stop it. If you reach there, you go further. Further avenues open up for you. So always remember that success is a journey and not a destination. And the road to success is like our Bombay Municipal Road, always under construction. But positive construction. The road to success is, you can keep on. Okay? Last, we'll end with a humorous example. Coca-Cola, you know? Success is like Coca-Cola. It comes in cans, C-A-N-S cans, not in can't. So say I can, don't say I can't. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you all enjoyed. Can talk also for some.